A violent explosion awaits every star in our universe, and Betelgeuse is no different. The cycle of life and death is a constant that is ever present in the universe. It is common for planets, stars, and even entire galaxies to fulminate as they reach the end of their life. However, to witness an act of such extreme celestial violence from Earth is a rare sight. Today, let's talk about what would happen if Betelgeuse exploded. A supernova is what happens when a star has reached the end of its life and explodes in a brilliant burst of light. Supernovae can briefly outshine entire galaxies and radiate more energy than our sun will in its entire lifetime. They're also the primary source of heavy elements in the universe. According to NASA, supernovae are the largest explosions that take place in space. Various civilizations recorded supernovae long before the telescope was invented in the 17th century. The oldest recorded supernova is RCW 86, which Chinese astronomers spotted in AD 185. According to NASA, records show that this guest star stayed in the sky for 8 months. The Crab Nebula, arguably the most famous supernova, was first spotted by Chinese and Korean astronomers who recorded this star explosion in their records in 1054. Native Americans may have seen it as well, according to rock paintings found in Arizona and New Mexico. The supernova that formed the Crab Nebula was so bright that those early astronomers could see it during the day. Other supernovae that were observed before the telescope was invented occurred in the years 393, 1006, 1181, 1572, and 1604. Famed astronomer Tycho Brahe, who observed the 1572 event, wrote about his observations of the new star in his book, De Nova Stella, which gave rise to the name Nova. The term supernova was first used by Walter Bade and Fritz Zwicky at Mount Wilson Observatory, who used it concerning an explosive event they observed called S. Andromedae, located in the Andromeda Galaxy. Scientists suggested that supernovas happen when ordinary stars collapse into neutron stars. According to research by the European Space Agency, on average, a supernova will occur once every 50 years in a galaxy the size of the Milky Way. The U.S. Department of Energy estimates that a star explodes every 10 seconds or so somewhere in the universe. About 10 million years ago, a cluster of supernovae created the local bubble, a 300 light-year long, peanut-shaped bubble of gas in the interstellar medium that surrounds our solar system. Exactly how a star dies depends in part on its mass. Our sun, for example, doesn't have enough mass to explode as a supernova, but with the right amount of mass, a star can burn out any fiery explosion. A supernova may occur in one of two ways. In a Type 1 supernova, a star accumulates matter from a nearby neighbor until a runaway nuclear reaction ignites. A Type 2 supernova happens when a star runs out of nuclear fuel and collapses under its gravity. A Type 2 supernova is arguably the more exciting of the two. For a star to explode as a Type 2 supernova, it must be several times more massive than the Sun. Estimates run from 8 to 15 solar masses. Like the Sun, it will eventually run out of hydrogen and then helium fuel at its core. However, it will have enough mass and pressure to fuse carbon. Next, gradually heavier elements build up at the center, and the star forms onion-like layers of material, with elements becoming lighter toward the outside of the star. Once the star's core surpasses a certain mass, it begins to implode. For this reason, these Type 2 supernovae are also known as core collapse supernovae. Eventually, the implosion bounces back off the core, expelling the stellar material into space and forming the supernova. What's left is an ultra-dense object called a neutron star, a city-sized object that packs the mass of the Sun in a small space. Type 2 supernova subcategories are classified based on their light curves, which describe how the intensity of the light changes over time. The light of Type 2L supernovae declines steadily after the explosion, while the light of Type 2P supernovae stays steady for a longer period before diminishing. Both types have the signature of hydrogen in their spectra. Astronomers think that stars much more massive than the Sun might not explode as a supernova. Instead, they collapse to form black holes. Type 1 supernovae lack a hydrogen signature in their light spectra and are generally thought to originate from white dwarf stars in a close binary star system. As the gas of the companion star accumulates onto the white dwarf is progressively compressed and sets off a runaway nuclear reaction inside that eventually leads to a cataclysmic supernova outburst. Astronomers use type 1A supernovae as standard candles to measure cosmic distances because all are thought to blaze with equal brightness at their peaks. Type 1B and 1C supernovae also undergo core collapse just as type 2 supernovae do, but they have lost most of their outer hydrogen layer. In 2014, scientists detected the faint, hard-to-locate companion star 2, a type 1B supernova. The search consumed 2 decades, as the companion star shone much fainter than the bright supernova. Recent studies have found that supernovae vibrate like giant speakers and emit an audible hum before exploding. In 2008, scientists caught a supernova in the act of exploding for the first time. While peering at her computer screen, astronomer Alicia Soderberg expected to see the small glowing smudge of a month-old supernova. But what she and her colleagues saw instead was a strange, extremely bright, 5-minute burst of X-rays. With that observation, they became the first astronomers to catch a star in the act of exploding. The new supernova was named SN2008D. Further study has shown that the supernova had some unusual properties that are being studied to this day. At about 950 times bigger than our sun, Betelgeuse is one of the biggest stars in our universe. But that comes with a price. Just like us, stars have a life expectancy, and Betelgeuse is no different. It's a ticking time bomb that's ready to go, but we're not sure when. So what if today was the day that Betelgeuse went out with a bang? How would the Earth be affected? And will our universe ever be the same? Betelgeuse is one of the closest stars to Earth at a distance of only 650 light years away. This makes it a fan favorite with professional and amateur astronomers alike. Betelgeuse is a red giant star, which means that when it reaches the end of its life, it will explode in a spectacular supernova, possibly even becoming a black hole in the process. Let's imagine that today, Betelgeuse calls it quits and puts on one heck of a cosmic light show. But before getting good seats for Betelgeuse's grand finale, what sort of damage could an exploding star do to Earth? Well, think of stars as being like nuclear power plants. If they explode, you're looking at a disaster of cosmic proportions. Anything within 50 light years of the exploding Betelgeuse will suffer massive shockwaves and be inundated with dust and radiation. However, astronomers predict that humanity would probably survive this celestial eruption. Down here on Earth, we are going to see a very bright light in the sky. It could even be visible during the day and bright enough to rival a full moon at night. This light show is expected to go on for quite some time. This is because the light has to travel 650 light years from its place in the universe to ours. This event will be breathtaking to behold, but will not affect life on Earth except for the light show at night. We're about 10 times too far away to feel any repercussions from this explosion. If we weren't, well, that would be another story. If we were too close to Betelgeuse when it explodes, our atmosphere and cells would be fried by the radiation and gamma waves. When you're exposed to high doses of radiation, it can burn and scar your skin, cause genetic mutations, and can ultimately be lethal. Gamma radiation in particular is incredibly powerful. It's pure energy, even more intense than light itself. If Betelgeuse were closer to Earth, it would be a literal and figurative lights out for all of us. Humans, animals, plants, you name it, it would all be toasted. An explosion that big, from a star that immense, would destroy life on Earth in seconds once the radiation hits us, even though the process of going supernova takes years. And even if we did have interplanetary ships to evacuate in time, Betelgeuse is so huge that there wouldn't be a planet in our solar system that's safe from the explosion. Thankfully, we're much too far from Betelgeuse to have any direct, observable, or harmful effects from the explosion. Betelgeuse is going to explode, but it will likely take another 100,000 years. When it does go, astronomers are going to have to rethink the structure of Orion. If you stargaze on a clear winter night, it's hard to miss the constellation Orion the Hunter, with his shield in one arm and the other arm stretched high to the heavens. Betelgeuse marks Orion's shoulder, and this star's strange dimming has captivated skygazers for thousands of years. Aboriginal Australians may have even worked it into their oral histories. Today, astronomers know that Betelgeuse varies in brightness because it's a dying red supergiant star with a diameter some 700 times larger than our sun. With all the speculation about what a Betelgeuse supernova would look like from Earth, Astronomers at the University of California have come up with simulations of the star's dying days. The astronomers say there's still uncertainty over how the supernova would play out, but they were able to augment their accuracy using observations taken during supernova 1987A, the closest known star to explode in centuries. The simulations show that the explosion will shine as bright as the half moon for more than 3 months. Humans would be able to see the supernova in the daytime sky for roughly a year, and it would be visible at night with the naked eye for several years as the supernova aftermath dims. By the time it fades completely, Orion will be missing its left shoulder. While there is no worry of any harm to life, the supernova could still impact Earth in some surprising ways. For example, many animals use the moon for navigation and are confused by artificial lights. Adding a second object as bright as the moon could be disruptive. It's not only wildlife that would be disturbed either. Ironically, astronomers themselves would have a hard time. Astronomical observations are already difficult when the moon is bright, and adding another bright light in the sky could hinder progress for years. And if Betelgeuse does defy the odds and blow up in our lifetimes, astronomers say there will be ample warning. Instruments on Earth would start detecting neutrinos or gravitational waves generated by the explosion as much as a day in advance. But for scientists, Betelgeuse doesn't have to explode to be interesting. It's big and bright, making it relatively easy to study. The star provides a unique opportunity to study a celestial body at the end of its life. Some fascinating physics is going on in the internal structure of Betelgeuse, and the best guess astronomers have as to what's going on stems from what they already know about the star and others like it. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this one, which talks about SpaceX's historic static fire test on its new Starship prototype. Do you think Betelgeuse will explode in our lifetime? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.